everyone. I'm Krista Seiden, Analytics Advocate at Google. And today I'm joined by John Mesh, who's a product manager on Google Optimize. In this quick tip video, John is going to go into detail about using the Optimize editor to do some really advanced edits. Now, if you missed our prior quick tip video on navigating the interface and using the editor, I would highly recommend checking those out because that's going to give you a good overview before you go ahead and jump into these advanced tips. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and hand it over to John.
Great. Thanks, Krista. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Now, I want to get some quick things out of the way. Now, one of the first things I want to show you here is at this top right here, there's a couple of buttons here. This first is the interactive mode. Now, interactive mode is really useful if you need to navigate around your site. For instance, if you have a particular part of your flow that's hard to get to just by typing in a URL. So that's a really useful thing to use right there. I'm actually going to go back to the main page. The other thing that I want to show you in that particular right corner is this little settings dialog. Now, this settings dialog is used for moving elements. Now, by default, what we've tried to do here is make it really reliable and easy and simple for people to move things around on the page. So, to show you what that looks like, if I want to just drag this particular button over to the left side, we've made that really easy so that I haven't broken the page or done anything too problematic with it. Now, I'm going to undo that and show you what that looks like when I change that for move anywhere. Now you'll see a couple of interesting things here. So first of all, if I move this out of the way, I've just moved the text. I haven't actually moved the whole element. And you can see why we kind of made that not the default option. So we want to make sure that you're successful, but we also want to give the power to people who really want that. So what I'm going to do here instead is use our hierarchy bar here to select a larger container, in which case I can move that a little bit more easily. Now it's going to still be behind that particular banner there, so we're just going to move it toward the center. Okay. So that's the settings dialog, and there's a couple of other detailed controls there you can read about in our Help Center. The next thing I want to focus on is this hierarchy bar up here. Now you can see as I'm clicking around that that's changing depending on what element I'm on, but it's not just for showing you the hierarchy of the page, it actually helps you navigate that page as well. So you can see here that I can actually click higher up in this hierarchy to see different sizes of elements. I can also go back down if I need to get to a particular thing that's a little bit lower. So maybe I want to go down here and move this down or something like that. But beyond selecting that, I can actually go even deeper. I'm going to go into this advanced selection dialog over here, and here you can see that I've got that same selector, and I can do things like change the options here of based on how my site is structured, or I can actually go and just type in more selectors or a different kind of selector here, and then add any of the changes that I want to add. So that's selection. There's one more thing I do want to show you about selection, and that's our multi-select capabilities. So we're going to go down to the bottom of the page, and I'm actually going to undo that change. Now, I want to change these product titles down here at the bottom to be a little bit larger. Now, I could do that one at a time, but instead what I'm going to do is just hold Shift, like you would expect on many other word processing programs. And you can see here I've got a select similar. Now, what that's going to do when I click that is actually choose the selector that helps grab all of those different pieces, and we try to do, again, a really good job of helping you be more efficient and quick at making these edits. But once I do that, I can very easily just go ahead and change that to a larger size for all three of those at one time, no problem. Okay, let's move on to editing now that we've covered selection. The first thing I want to cover with editing is actually our CSS editor. Now that's this icon up here. I can go here and you'll see a couple changes that already show up in this particular dialog. And these are the changes that I just made with the WYSIWYG editor. So I can go back and I can change those in a little more detail, or I can add new ones. Now, these aren't just applied at the element level. They're actually applied at the top of the page as the page is loading. And that means that you're less likely to encounter Flickr when you're running your test. You can, in the change dialog, actually choose to run that on the element level as well if you want, though. So that's the CSS dialog. Next, I want to show you what it looks like to insert HTML. Now, my developer gave me some code here to add sort of a lightbox pop-up. And what we're going to do here is just grab any old element and insert this HTML by copying and pasting that. And I actually have this control of whether I want to append that or insert that before or after, exactly how I want to deal with that. So you can see, there we go. That's the new element that just came up. And then I can just deal with that as I did for any other element. I can change the size, etc. Now, what happened when I just changed that size, though, is if we look at our change list, is I actually added another style there, and I didn't really want to do that. I wanted to be a little more performant, so I'm going to undo that change and go back and change the actual HTML that I added. So I can edit that change right here and just go ahead and type in the new height that I want for that dialog. Okay, and that's fixed up, no problem. So you can see there, that's where you can edit all of your different changes or delete some of the ones that you don't particularly want, things like that. Finally, I want to cover adding JavaScript to this page. So if there's a script that you want to run that might do something more advanced than the editor, or maybe there's something that's specific to your site that you want to run, it's very easy to add that. And it's not just at the top or the bottom of the page that you can run that. You can actually run that anywhere you want. So maybe you wanted to do something like add a scrolling, you know, light box or something like that on top of these images, and you want to do that right after maybe this larger container has loaded. So I'm going to select that, and I'm going to run JavaScript, and I'm going to run that right after the closing tag. And then I could add whatever script that I wanted to be able to make that light box and that kind of scrolling behavior appear. So that's how you can add JavaScript here to your tests. Okay, so that's all of the editing functionality. The last thing that I want to cover is the validation. Now, one of the key parts of validation is, again, always looking at what these looks like on a different device. So let's go ahead and go over to a Nexus 7 and see what that looks like on a tablet. Now, in this particular case, it looks like everything's turned out pretty well. But looks like that move anywhere command that I ran kind of overlaps with some of my other text. So I maybe need to go back and tweak that a little bit. And I could do that right here as well, no problem. The other thing that is really important to note about this is it's not just screen size. Many of you who have apps might want to run a particular promotion for that app based on the operating system. And what we're doing here is actually using Chrome development tools to change the user agent of this particular page as it's loading. So the server actually thinks this is an Android tablet. So there's some pretty advanced stuff that we've done there. Okay, so that's one step of validation. And the last thing that I wanted to cover is this other little dialog right up here. This is our diagnostics dialog. Now you can see in this particular case, the page was modified after the initial load. Now don't get too scared off by that. That's very common in a JavaScript-based environment. But what's really important about this is it's good to check this test, not only in the editing different modes and the mobile editing mode here, but also in preview mode, and to make sure that that's the highest fidelity representation and you can see exactly what your test is going to look like on your page. Okay, that's a quick tour of all the advanced features of the editor. Thanks so much.
Great, thank you, John.